Hi folks, my name is Srinivasa Kollori and welcome to the beginner series for Azure MySQL. In this video, we will walk through some of the core concepts for our flexible server offering. We will start with exploring customer considerations on their MySQL journey, along with a brief recap of the flexible server architecture. We will then step into the core concepts of our flexible server offering and how one could speed up application development by leveraging these features. The first step of a MySQL customer journey is usually the research phase where various solutions are compared on technical merit along with the total cost of ownership. Next is the trial phase where one signs up for the service followed by the onboarding phase. If a satisfactory trial happens, customers would proceed to the planning and the POC phase for a more thorough evaluation of the solution, including cost considerations. Successful POCs lead to performance tuning phase. After maximizing performance, a more broad-based deployment to production occurs along with expansion. We have various video modules in our beginner series which will touch upon all milestones pertaining to a customer journey. In this module, we will focus our attention on the research and trial phases by understanding the core concepts in the flexible server offering. Azure Database for MySQL lets customers focus on application development rather than database management. Flexible Server is a fully managed community database with a lower TCO compared to on-premise MySQL installations. Flexible Server is easy to set up, operate, and scale. Developers can also take advantage of the built-in security features. Time to market can be reduced by building apps faster with the Azure ecosystem. We will only briefly recap the flexible server architecture. Please refer to the first video in this series for a deep dive on the architecture. The flexible server architecture allows users to opt for high availability within single availability zone and across multiple availability zones. The architecture allows for zone redundant backup storage and AZ co-location with applications. Before we proceed to covering the features, let us spend a few moments to explore cost considerations. It is important for developers to budget and forecast their cloud spend. This can be easily done using the Azure Pricing Calculator tool. Azure Pricing Calculator provides an easy interface to calculate one's estimated hourly and monthly costs. Developers can also save and share cost estimates with other decision makers in their company when they sign into the tool. Let us now navigate to the Pricing Calculator. As you can see, we have navigated to the Pricing Calculator webpage. Let us navigate to the left-hand side of the web page where you will see the product categories. I'm going to click on the databases category and then navigate to the MySQL bucket. Once we do that, we'll see that a view estimates button has been created. We will navigate to the Azure Database for MySQL portion of the page. And the very first thing that I'm going to do is change the region in the dropdown. I'm going to switch to the central US. And the tool allows for exploring cost estimates for all available regions. I will also change the deployment option to flexible server since that is of interest. I will leave the computing tier and the computing instances unchanged. We have a separate video where we'll go into much more detail on these two items. When it comes to the saving options, we have three options displayed: pay as you go and the 1 year and the 3 year reserved instances. For now, I'll go with the pay as you go model. Next thing I'm going to do is bump up the number of servers from 1 to 3 servers, and I will reduce the number of hours to 100. I will leave the storage unchanged at 5 GB, and I'll also leave the IOPS unchanged at 0. I will leave the storage redundancy options as LRS. One could also explore GRS while working with the tool. As you can see, the tool provides a very quick estimate for 3 servers that could be run for about 100 hours with a storage size of 5 GB, and it would cost the developer about $58.61 in a month for the upkeep of these servers. As mentioned, this tool is a great way to budget and forecast cost estimates very, very early in the development journey. Let us now switch back to looking at some of the core concepts in the flexible server offering. Flexible server takes snapshot backups of the data files and stores them in local redundant storage. The server also performs transaction logs backup and stores them in local redundant storage. These backups allow you to restore a server to any point in time within your configured backup retention period. The default backup retention period is 7 days. You can optionally configure the database backup from 1 to 35 days. All backups are encrypted using AES-256-bit encryption for the data stored at rest. In flexible server, performing a restore creates a new server from the original server's backups. There are two types of restore available. Point-in-time restore is available with either backup redundancy option and creates a new server in the same region as your original server. Geo restore is available only if you configured your server for geo redundant storage, and it allows you to restore your server to the geo paired region. The estimated time for the recovery of the server depends on several factors such as the size of the databases, number of transaction logs, activity, and network bandwidth. Performing a point-in-time restore creates a new server from the flexible server's backups in the same region as your source server. It is created with the original server's configuration for the compute tier, number of vCores, storage size, and the backup retention period. Also, tags and settings such as virtual network and firewall are inherited from the source server. The restored server's compute and storage tier configuration and security settings can be changed once the restore is completed. Point-in-time restore is useful in multiple scenarios, such as accidental deletion of data when a user drops an important table, user application accidentally overwrites good data. You can also choose between the latest restore point, the customer restore point, and the fastest restore point. Flexible server supports two ways to configure connectivity to your servers, and those are the public and private access methods. In the private access method, you can deploy your flexible server into your Azure virtual network. Azure virtual networks provide private and secure network communication. Resources in a virtual network can communicate through private IP addresses. In the public access method, your flexible server is accessed through a public endpoint. The public endpoint is a publicly resolvable DNS address. The phrase allowed IP addresses refers to a range of IPs you can choose to give permission to access your server. These permissions are called your firewall rules. We will explore networking in detail in a separate video. Flexible server allows configuring high availability with automatic failover. The high availability solution is designed to ensure that committed data is never lost because of failures and that the database won't be a single point of failure in your software architecture. When you deploy a server with zone redundant HA, two servers will be created, a primary server in one availability zone, a standby replica server that has the same configuration as the primary server in terms of compute tier, size, storage, and network configuration. This will be created in another availability zone of the same Azure region. You can choose the availability zone for the primary and the standby replica. Placing the standby database servers and standby applications in the same zone reduces latency. It also allows you to better prepare for disaster recovery scenarios and zone down scenarios. We will explore high availability in much more detail in other videos. Flexible server performs periodic maintenance to keep your managed database secure, stable, and up to date. During maintenance, the server gets new features, updates, and patches. You can schedule maintenance during a specific day of the week and a time window within that day. When specifying preferences for the maintenance schedule, you can pick a day of the week and a time window. If you don't specify, the system will pick times between 11 p.m. and 7 a.m. in your server's region time. You can also define different schedules for each flexible server in your Azure subscription. Either way, the system will alert you 5 days before running any maintenance. The system will also let you know when maintenance is started and when it is successfully completed. Notifications about upcoming scheduled maintenance can be emailed to specific addresses. They can also be sent to Azure Resource Manager roles. They can be pushed as notifications to an Azure app or even as an SMS to mobile devices. Lastly, let us look at monitoring. The MySQL engine provides many different server variables and parameters that can be used to configure and tune engine behavior. Some parameters can be set dynamically during runtime, while others are static, requiring a server restart in order to apply. Azure Database for MySQL exposes the ability to change the value of various MySQL parameters using the Azure portal or the Azure CLI. You can manage your parameters using the server parameters tab. The server parameters are configured with the default and recommended value when you create the server. The server parameter blade on the Azure portal shows both the modifiable and non-modifiable server parameters. The non-modifiable parameters are grayed out. The list of supported server parameters is constantly growing. Use the server parameters tab in the Azure portal to view the full list and configure the server parameter values. Flexible Server provides various metrics to understand how your workload is performing, and based on this data, you can understand the impact on your server and applications. Metrics are numeric values that describe some aspect of the resources of your server at a particular time. Monitoring your server's resources helps you troubleshoot and optimize your workload by allowing you to monitor what matters the most to you. Monitoring the right metrics helps you keep the performance, reliability, and availability of your server and applications. For example, in Flexible Server, you can monitor host CPU percent, active connections, IO percent, and host memory percent to identify when there is a performance impact. From there, you may have to optimize your workload scale vertically by changing computing tiers or scaling horizontally by using read replicas. All Azure metrics have a 1-minute frequency, and each metric provides 30 days of history. You can also configure alerts on the metrics. To learn more about Flexible Server, please visit our Flexible Server for MySQL page on docs.microsoft.com. Check out the Flexible Server intro article on techcommunity.microsoft.com. We have wonderful case studies of companies using Flexible Server on our customers.microsoft.com page. We also have multiple blogs published for Flexible Server on azure.microsoft.com. And last but not the least, visit our free trial page linked in the description to start your free trial. Also, please reach out to us via email and follow us on our official Twitter handle for many more updates. As always, thanks for joining us and hope to see you soon.